Hello, everybody. It's really a pleasure for me to take the floor of this webinar. It's my first webinar, so it was really very exciting for me, the preparation and also joining it. First, I want to thank your Danke for this invitation to have an opportunity to make this presentation. I will share now my computer to be able to see the presentation which I prepared for you. Just give me a sign if you see it. Dan, is it okay? Okay. So today we will have a really very interesting subject to discuss, and I hope that this will be really a discussion, not only a lecture, because I will share my experience and the experience of our organization, but it will be really helpful if you have a question, then at the end to have time to discuss and to make this really useful. Because with the communication, you know, it's you don't know all the answers, and you never know the right answer. For example, today, probably many of the young people who want to participate to this webinar are joining the protest against the new Procureur of Bulgaria. So this is a kind of risk to all communication activities, as we know from the practice. So my name is Radostina Tzenova. I'm communication expert of Bulgarian Biodiversity Foundation. I have a really interesting experience because I started to work for Biodiversity Foundation exactly when I graduated from the university, but as an ecologist. And graduating as ecologist, I started to work as a public relation officer, and it was for the wetlands. And it was quite difficult for me to manage all the things and the requirements. So 5 years later, I graduated public relations in the University of Sofia, but I'm still combining ecology and communication, and still working in the same field and at the same organization for more than 20 years, which is very challenging and really very interesting all the time, because the situation with the nature conservation in Bulgaria and probably all over the world is very dynamic, and the things are changed very quickly. It's the same with the communication. There are many other fields in the world that are changing very quick, but the things with the communication are really very dynamic, because I remember when I started to work 20 years ago, it was quite a different situation, and the channels and the messages which we have were quite different. Now it's the situation is totally different, and you need all the time to learn, to study, to qualify, and to know all the new things which appear in the world of communication. You know, there were no social media, no Instagram, no such mobile phones, now you have the world in your hand. But sometimes it's very difficult to make an act. So let's start with this, that in general, public awareness and concern about the nature is growing. And especially we see the difference with the climate change and the acceptance of the society of this, all these topics. So this is the positive news. Maybe finally people understand that our impact over the nature is too high and is no more invisible. So we should take our role and to take the responsibility to look after the our only home which we have, the earth. And in all this process, the communication has a key role, because communicating effectively about sustainable lifestyle is a big challenge. Because one needs to consider not only what to communicate, but how to communicate it. The important factors of success include content, messenger, choice of media, and tone of the message. And we will talk about this. Let's start first with Natura 2000 and why do we need to communicate this Natura 2000. I will not speak in details about the network, but it's really the largest protected network in the world, with this 27,800 sites. This ecological network is really something very huge and even enormous. So we should celebrate all these achievements which we have with Natura 2000 and think about positive, not negative, about the network. It's important to connect nature for our own reasons, because everybody has different can be considered in different ways. Understanding those motivations of the people are important for successful communication in the future. Also, the other reason is to win support from people. Natura 2000 network still is not enough known from the Europeans, which is a pity, because it exists more than 25 years and there are still many people who didn't know anything about Natura 2000. It's necessary to ensure how to manage Natura 2000 sites and to make this more effectively and solve all the conflicts which appear during the management of these sites. To highlight the added value that Natura 2000 provides, because very often the people who work in the nature conservation, they don't put enough attention on the importance of the preserved nature, not only for the species and habitats, but also for people. And especially during the last few years, the European Commission pay attention to all these socio-economic indicators and try to define in the conservation work, not only pure conservation work for habitats, but to underline the benefits for the people, for the well-being of the people, and for the improving of their own lifestyle. Why is it Natura 2000 site relevant to the whole society? Very often, and still there are many questions about the relevance of the network, especially in the new members of the European Union. Bulgaria is experienced because we joined 2007 in the EU, but we still have many problems with the Natura 2000 network, and we will share some of our experience later on during the webinar. It's important to highlight national or local importance of the Natura 2000 site. It's really important to mention that there are some countries which are in the top of the lists regarding the number of the declared Natura 2000 sites, and Croatia, Bulgaria, Spain, France, and Slovenia are among the top countries in the Europe. It's necessary to highlight how people identify and can relate to a Natura 2000 site. This is something which is really missing in the many of the Natura 2000 site management, because people accept the network just like its existence, and they don't find their personal role in this site in many of the cases. Also, to show the importance of biodiversity in our lives, and to combine rationality and emotion to support the benefits and values of Natura 2000 site. And let's start with the outcome, with the vision of Natura 2000 communication. It is a direct response to public concern over the rapid loss of nature in Europe, and people should be informed of what is being done to meet their concerns. I think that in Europe, we still believe that we made enough for our nature, and that the big problems, the big conservation problems are in Africa, in South America, and, but not exactly here, because we've made all the best, which is not the fact. Natura 2000 also opened the opportunities for the public to discover and enjoy Europe's own wealth of natural heritage. It's remains largely unknown to the vast majority of Europeans. It's really a pity, because the Commission make this Eurobarometer and study the attitude of the Europeans, and there are still high percentage of the people who didn't recognize Natura 2000 sites, and they don't know that there are such a huge network on our continent. It's a European initiative. For the first time, all countries working together to conserve nature using the same strong legislative framework, and it's really a very big success. Good job of this European initiative. Probably some of you remember that a few years ago there was a big campaign, Nature Alert, led by all of the main environmental NGOs in Europe. And the idea was to stop the changes of these two directives on which base Natura 2000 is working, Habitat and Birds Directive. And the campaign was really a huge success for all people who care about the nature in Europe, because we collect more than half million signatures of the petitions of Nature Alert, and there was a very big campaign, a lot of statesmen of different organizations and governments. And finally, we win, and the process for opening and for changing of the directives didn't start it. There are many myths and misconceptions around Natura 2000, which also need to be corrected. I don't know how it's exactly in your countries, but in Bulgaria, Natura 2000 for many years remains not very well accepted word in Bulgaria. The next step is to clarify our audiences. Who do we talk to? This is one of the important part because there are many various audiences, and we should be more specific than communicate to the general public or communicate to all stakeholders. And it's necessary to precise the communication, the target groups which we will work on, because this is the main part of the communication. In our team, when we make a communication strategy or communication plan, we try to define the target audiences as more precise as possible, and to define the different channels which will be used for each target group, because this is the half of the communication work. If you know who you want to influence and why, it will be easier after that to find the way how to make it. Because, for example, you should clarify, are you targeting the governmental institution, or students, or consumers of healthy food? It depends on your objectives and your purpose, your goal. If you make your homework and sit down with your team and make a real map of the stakeholders, it will be easier for you to understand how to achieve the your goals, because the target audiences are these groups who will be helpful for your work. You don't communicate with someone just because of the communication. You use this audience because you have a certain purpose to change the legislation, to change the attitude, to inform someone about the importance of a species or habitat, and so on. The next very important part is building relationships. A lot of the Nature 2000 communication is personal between the staff of the Natura 2000 sites and the stakeholders. But the main question here is what happens when there is no staff. In Bulgaria, we still don't have orders for many of the declared protected Natura 2000 areas, and we don't have any staff of Natura 2000 sites, which is the big problem. But because the case with Natura 2000 is very interesting, I want to share some of our experience here in Bulgaria, and also to ask Jordanka to join me and to share some of our experience 10 years ago. How we started in Bulgaria, the establishing of Natura 2000 network just before the joining of Bulgaria and the EU, we have obligations to establish the network. The government make a very clever decision and give this very difficult task to NGOs. Two biggest NGOs in Bulgaria, Bulgarian Society for the Protection of Birds, which is BirdLife partner, and Green Balkans Federation. They received a mandate from the government to study and to fulfill all the formulars for Natura 2000 sites. It was very difficult work on the field. All the other NGOs which have proper information for different sites on which they work provide detailed information too. And the network and the proposals for the network were made. But at the same time, there weren't any communication at all from the side of the government for the establishment of this network. It was totally untransparent process with a lot of myths and rumors and logically there were many fights between the environmentalists and the local people who inhabit the Natura 2000 areas. It was not clear what will happen with their land, what will happen with when they are into the this network. And there was nothing from the Ministry of Environment, nothing from the government. Everything was put on the to the NGOs, and they were the enemies, and it was quite easy for the government. And for us, it was very difficult to manage this situation and to talk with such different stakeholders in the area of the whole country, and at the same time to continue to discuss with the government, because the network was not accepted as it should be, and even almost 20 years later, there are still many problems with the network. But I will ask Jordanka now to share some memories from this interesting campaign which we have every Thursday.
Yes, because we are speaking about communication, when we are speaking about Natura 2000 establishment, we must say again that there was no communication from the state. There was totally no communication. So all the communication had to be done together with the scientific work had to be done by NGOs, citizens and scientists. And here we are presenting a very interesting long-term demonstrations that happened every Thursday in front of the building of the Council of Ministers in Bulgaria, because the Council of Ministers are the one who should approve the Natura 2000 list and send it to European Commission. That's why these demonstrations happened in front of the Council of Ministers every Thursday when they had actually their council. And this is one example to show that when we want to say something and when we want to be heard, it's not obligatory that a lot of people participate, like big demonstration of thousands of people. A communication action can also be an action that is done by 10 people or 20 people, but have some interesting idea and make the action in a time that it will be really put in media. In this case, every Thursday, because of the Council of Ministers, there were a lot of media that actually go there because of the Minister Council. But at the same time, we were making some actions that were really nice to be recorded. You see some of the pictures, but we were playing like we're in a soap opera and nobody is deciding about Natura 2000, or we were constructing from some materials illegal buildings and connected this action to the fact that while we're not accepting Natura 2000 areas, during that time, actually, illegal buildings happened, and after that, there will be no point of Natura 2000. We were gathering, I don't know, small coins to propose to the government that we buy these valuable areas in order to protect them and to have more easy way of their protection. So really, actions that were interesting to be recorded by the media. And because of that, we gathered, focused the attention of the media. And every week there was some information about Natura 2000 in Bulgaria, because as I said, there was no information at all about Natura 2000. This protest happened for, I don't know, maybe 4 or 5 months every week. It was really a long-term one. And was a way to attract the attention. It played its role. I mean, now Bulgaria has 34% Natura 2000 areas coverage in the country, which is of course not due only to these actions, but also to the role of scientists, NGOs that joined their positions, made statements, meetings, and participated in all consultation processes going on European level. I don't know if you want to add something more on that.
Yeah, and what you mentioned in the beginning, that it was not necessary to have too many people, but to have very creative ones and to have very interesting play every time. The second photo you see that people are with pyjamas and they ask who is crazy now because of the Natura 2000. It was really a fantastic campaign with no funds, but a lot of very creative ideas. And the other positive thing of this Natura 2000 case in Bulgaria was the establishment of For the Nature Coalition. It is the coalition among all active environmental organizations and citizens in Bulgaria. And before that, we work on a different level, even fighting against each other. But after this case and Natura 2000 establishment, we understand that really creation of a unit of united organization between all of us will be more helpful and easier to work and to communicate and to try to change the situation, especially here in Bulgaria. The next important step is the messaging. How to prepare our interesting messages, story, interesting, good stories, and to take attention of the people and the target audiences. I will give you another example from our work. Our Biodiversity Foundation has 25 years experience on the wetlands here on the Black Sea coast, and we work very actively for Atanasovs Lake, one very special Natura 2000 area. And a few years ago, it was necessary to make an exhibition for the lake. It was very a long and very difficult process, how to make this interactive, traveling, very interesting exhibition, which to present the lake to people who know it and to people who didn't know it, and also to present it to very varying audience, from kids to adults. So the main question was what is our message and what we want to share with the public, and how to make it on a way which is acceptable for the kids and for the adults. So we choose this name of the exhibition, Symbiotic, which is about the symbiosis between man and lake. But at the same time, especially for the younger people, we are using a tale for lake, birds, salt, and people. So using the same exhibition, using the same communication channels, we are reaching different targets through focusing of the our communication messages. And it was quite interesting for the students and for the older people who visited the exhibition. It traveled to 13 different places in Bulgaria, and was experienced by more than 30,000 people all over the country. And when you are really focused on the message and the story which you want to tell, then in any case it will be success. When we talk about the channels and the techniques which you use to share the communication, I want to show you this graphic about the different type of media. Now we have our own media, like the website, the blog, content which we produce. This is the channels which we can manage easily, because they depend only from us and from our wishes. There are some earned media, like using the media relations, blogger relations, and very modern influencer relations. And these are medias which we want to reach and want to have on our side, because it's very easy to reach a huge audience, especially now with these influencers and their million followers. It's quite interesting. There was a case in the summer when one of these bloggers influencer organized a trip to Musala, the highest peak in Bulgaria. And you can imagine how many followers he has, because for this trip there were 5,000 people who came at the same time, at the same place, and they passed into the national park. And there was a big conflict, a big problem, because the rangers of the park write him an act, and he was punished because he didn't expect so many people to participate, and didn't know that they will enter a national park, and they will, which is not allowed by the law. So with the influencer, it's not very easy, because many of them, they spreading information which is not very reliable, but the kids especially who follow them believe in every word they say. But it's also important to use them in our work and to make them fan of the nature, and to use them in the proper way. Also, there are some paid channels, advertising, Google advertisement, you know, even through social media. There are more paid opportunities versus the free, as it was a few years ago. And the other part is the shared channels. These are social media, word of mouth, and referrals. So the mixture of all these channels make the communication mixture and give us the very simple answer, which are the possible channels to deliver our messages to different audience. It's very important to learn how to use the right tools and channels for the right audience. For example, every January we organize a special sport event, half marathon Athanasos Kuleik, and we are our main audience is sportists, active people from all over the country, and for us the first meeting 3 years ago was quite interesting, because we found totally different people who never complain that it's cold, it's raining, or something like this. Very positive and very open-minded people who are interested for the lake, but at the same time, they are very focused on their main job to cycle or to run 21 kilometers to the borders of Athanasos Kuleik Managed Reserve. For us, it was a very interesting experience and very successful. We made this in partnership with a local NGO from Burgas, Green Stranja, who are very experienced in organizing tours in nature and some sport events. And this is the way to promote Athanasos Kuleik in very different target audience and to reach totally different people, not only from Burgas, but from the whole country. It's very important to have a good planning and to have a strategy or a communication plan. This is something important and very helpful for the work of an organization or institution dealing with Natura 2000 site, and also to identify key contacts for professional communication. Sometimes it's better not to speak too much or not to write too many words, but to use images, video or photo, because a picture is worth 1,000 words. Especially this year's the visual channels are very important to reach not only young people but all people, because when you have interesting picture or viral video, you will reach 1,000 people, because now everybody's receive so much information, has so many different information channels that it's not easy to reach, and sometimes interesting photo and video is very successful. We have such experience this summer with the flamingo. You know, summer is not very busy season for the news and for the media. So when you put a video of flamingo in Athanasovsko Lake, there was enormous interest from all national media. All the TV crew arrived on the lake, shot videos, pictures, so on. In the middle of August, it was a national news shared even through the Facebook profile of the mayor, of all kind of media. And it's something which you can benefit without many efforts. So just in brief, what is necessary for the effective communication to be relevant to your audience, to be easy to understand what you say, to be memorable. If your audience can't recall what your message was hours, days or weeks later, it hasn't been effective message. And always to require a response. This is a very important part of the communication. We see now with the social media that there are many people who like something. But liking something in internet is not like taking action in the field. And that's why asking and looking for adequate response of your message is very important for the effective communication. It's not not expensive, as we mentioned before. Sometimes it's necessary just to have a good idea, a good video or photo, and to have enormous success. Now I want to share some experience how European Commission tried to increase the awareness for Natura 2000. In 2014, they established a special award, Natura 2000 award, in order to promote this to reward excellence in the management of Natura 2000 sites and showcase the added value of the network for local economies. To pay tribute to all these who work tirelessly to make Natura 2000 a success, drawing public attention to its achievement. It is really a very good idea to make this a world with five different categories: communication, conservation, social, economic, transboundary, and partnership. And the ceremony is every second year. It's the annual award ceremony. And it's good way to promote all this Natura 2000 site and all these teams who work actively for their conservation and promotion. In 2016, Bulgaria has a winner. It was our project for the Balkans and the people, nature protection and sustainable rural development, who is implemented by 10 partners from Bulgaria and Switzerland. And it was really a very big success for the team, and very good communication tools, because all the media, even all the government sites promote this award, and it was really beneficial for all farmers who work in nine Natura 2000 areas in Bulgaria. Sending nomination for this award is very, very useful communication tool to reach European audience and to reach media who are not so easy. In 2018, we were part of the nominations and part of the finalists of the Natura 2000 award with our project, The Salt of Life, in communication category. It was very interesting because it's a conservation project, but with very good communication results and successes. So we didn't win the award then, but we were invited to make a special performance for the ceremony of the awards in Brussels. And these are the dancer who made their dance, The Lake. There was a special video made for Atanasovsko Lake and our activities there, and this special dance. It was very interesting on this stage to make such a performance. Even the commissioner was very impressed, and the dance was fantastic. We were invited because we have a special chapter in our website, saltoflife.biodiversity.bg, which is especially for all these artists who are inspired by the lake. And we have different categories: musicians, video, design, architecture, photographers, performance, and all this related to Atanasovsko Lake. I will give you the link after that in the materials of the presentation. And it's interesting to see how one lake could be inspiration for so many and so different artists and who are impressed by the colors, the shape, the smell, and the inhabitants of the lake. The European Commission also was impressed by the site and invite us to select artists who are able to make a performance. The winner this year, as I say, were not us, but was the team, the Spain team, who was the main reason to establish Natura 2000 Day on the European level. And officially in 2017, European Commission started to celebrate the whole Europe to celebrate May 21st as the European Natura 2000 Day. It is quite interesting initiative. You see these people with hands like a butterfly. This is the sign of Natura 2000 Day. And it's a good initiative to visit Natura 2000 site, to make a special event, and even to put it in this website and to mark it on the map of all these initiatives. It's important to say that when people experience and benefit from nature, they are more likely to appreciate and care for it. This is what we believe and what we are trying to do in our work, to experience people and to show what are the benefits from the nature. Here I want to show you one very interesting video, which is exactly the dance.
Yes, we'll lose one fifth of the entire species on the planet. And if trends continue, we'll lose half our species.
Радост
не се ли виждам?
Да, отвори браузъра.
Е, сега ще го пусна.
Ocean acidification is a probable eventuality resulting from anthropogenic carbon dioxide emissions. There is a global loss of
ecosystems.
As meteorological
term, ne.
Each of the six mass global extinction. Experts warn that within the next 30 years we'll lose one fifth of the entire species on the planet.
Вече се вижда, само го пусни отново. И на full screen.
Each of the six mass global extinction. Experts warn that within the next 30 years we'll lose one fifth of the entire species on the planet. And if trends continue, we'll lose half our species for the next 100 years. Quarter of our mammal species are at risk of dying out in the wild.
But is anybody listening?
Humankind's relentless pursuit of economic growth is causing habitat destruction worldwide, and many of our vital ecosystems are close to the edge. Ocean acidification is a probable eventuality, resulting from anthropogenic carbon dioxide emissions. There is no loss of ecosystem functionality as meteorological turbulence leads to diminishing our forestation potential, reducing hydro production, but it's subterranean biomass and agribusiness.
Are we failing to communicate? Have we forgotten what first inspired our love of nature? All the evidence shows that the single most important factor behind taking action is our childhood experience. The wellspring of our commitment, comes from the emotional high we reach when in contact with nature. But how can this wonder be harnessed to change our behavior? Showing the loss of animals in faraway places may pull a few heartstrings, even attract donations. But does it really change our behavior? What if you're able to communicate to people the wonder of nature that surrounds them? And promote education that leads to awareness of threatened species and habitats they live in. In all parts of the world, we're beginning to see that public awareness does lead to change, where people can see the benefits from making their own contribution. It's not the depressing accounts of the wildlife we are losing that moves us. It's awe and wonder, enhanced by understanding, that can inspire us to take action. It's love, not loss.
You see, this video illustrate.
I used to manage my team's spreadsheets.
Just sorry. Can you see the presentation now? Dan?
Yes, yes.
Oh, okay.
You have to go to your slide.
Yeah. Okay. Also, I want to share something which I like very much about from UNESCO map brand and story toolkit. Last time, Catherine talked about the biosphere reserves, but look, their values. They are all our values too, but made on a very interesting way. Celebrate life, empower people, model solutions, and belong together. And how simply explained, we celebrate people and nature, we enable participation, we explore new ways every day, and we are part of something bigger. Also, I would like to recommend you this initiative, hashtag Nature for All. It's also IUCN initiative, global movement to inspire love of nature. It's very interesting. I will put this with the documents after the presentation, an action guide for inspiring love of nature, how to bring children into nature, find and share the fun in nature, use urban getaways, share cultural roots, and so on. Bird life has very interesting theory that this word biodiversity is not very well accepted by the people, and this is the reason to have difficulties with the communication of biodiversity. And they give the example that David Attenborough never mentioned the word biodiversity, which is too complicated and not understandable for people, but always refer to nature. Maybe there is something true in this, because we as Biodiversity Foundation many years has difficulties to explain what exactly is biodiversity. The other very interesting initiative of IUCN is this Youth Voices Curriculum Sourcebook. again, especially for the youth people, which are very important now to because we rely on them for the future. Here are some other videos which we will watch by yourself. I just want to mention this amazing campaign which Conservation International created a few years ago. I think that probably many of us know or remember this, Nature is Speaking. And famous actors speaking with the voice of home, ice, Mother Nature, the ocean. And it was really very inspiring and very influencing the all people who watch these videos. The other very useful communication tool is the mobile applications. This is one apps for the Marema Park, how to identify species of flora and fauna. It's very interesting. It's a pity that only for this area, but probably in every country there are many good examples. In Bulgaria we have SmartBird. It's an app made by Bulgarian Society for the Protection of Birds, which is one very good example how you can check the birds which you observe during your field trip and put it directly into the database of the society and to be used by different scientific work. I took some examples which are also very interesting. If we scale micro and macro, there is a very good micro example, biodiversity. When you adopt a bee, plant community gardens and support urban agriculture. It's something very small compared to the big conservation goals, let's say. But it's something that works and that has a very good local effect. The other campaign is for the love of let's act on climate change to protect our families, our hobbies, our lifestyles, and our well-being. And you see, for the love of fishing, of summer, of herons, of chocolate, it's also a very interesting campaign. WWF, our colleagues who are very creative and they always have very interesting communication campaign. I remember in 2007 when we organized a campaign for Stranja. They work with the advertisement agency, Ogilvy and Ogilvy, which produced a fantastic campaign with big pictures of different mountains in Bulgaria, and especially for Stranja for sale. And it was a very good communication effect. This is for the wildlife. You remember there was a selfie campaign with the tiger, with gorillas. This is another perspective, loss versus gain. You see, save paper, save the planet. The survival of the forest is directly connected to what we consume. And you see, if you consume more paper, the more the planet is suffering. Nature for All, it's the same initiative which I mentioned with this book before. So pay attention to it. It's quite interesting. More people experience, connect with, and share their love of nature. And then we have more support for its conservation, something which we believe too. What are the main ideas for the communication? Watch the nature. It's the easier way to become familiar and closer to nature if you see the inhabitants. And field trips and visiting such a special place are the way to become closer. Sport in the nature, it's something which is very actual now in Bulgaria. There are many active people now who are using their free time to go in the nature, to cycling, to run, to jogging, and really to have fun in the nature. So it's better to use these people who are open-minded and who want to participate actively in different kind of activities. We are trying to do this. Have fun or be healthy in the nature. It's important for people to understand their own benefit from the nature, not only to see that it's important for the pelicans, for the avocet, for the bear or the wolf, but that there is a concrete benefit for them. So all the time we are trying to show them what are the healthy benefits, what are the benefits for the health using this mat from Athanasov's colleague or the lay, the medical lay. Always starting with the kids. This is the main task, because they are easier to be involved, easier to communicate with them. Bulgarian Biodiversity Foundation has very good experience with organizing this biodiversity carnival. We started 10 years ago here in Burgas, but we organize it also in Sofia and different towns in the country. But here in Burgas, it's really a big tradition supported by the municipality and the Ministry of Environment. And it's a really a huge celebration, holiday for the kids. There's an open-air stage when they go and present their costumes and make some small performance. And it's amazing how they present different animal, plants. The only it's necessary only to be from Bulgarian fauna and flora. Species from other continents are not acceptable. Last years, the festivals become very popular, and especially the festivals in the nature. There are different formats and different continuation of these festivals, but people really like to go to the nature and to see the connection with the culture, with education, music, and different entertainments. And if there is a cause, then it's better. Here we organize a 6-year salt festival, one very interesting event. Making this connection between the lake, the salt, the birds, and the people. inviting famous musicians to play on the festival, organizing activities for young and for old people. This is a picture from Natura Fest in the capital of Bulgaria, in the heart of Sofia, also very good event. It's very successful if you combine with food and cuisine. It's very attractive. People are getting more and more acquainted with the bio food, with the special care for their health, and they are very interested when there is something healthy to degustate, to taste and to try. This is a famous chef in Bulgaria who is cooking on this Natura Fest in Sofia. Also, pay attention to nice looking souvenir and products to attract the consumers, because this is also very good advertisement of the species and habitats which we want to protect and to communicate for. During our work, we understand that the photographers are very important and very strong group, and it's good if you have them on your site and if you organize a special event for them, photo planners, exhibitions and so on. Then your site become famous and popular for them. And even in exhibitions which has nothing in common with nature conservation, they put a lot of pictures of nature, because they become really familiar and enthusiastic about the sites. The exhibitions are still preferred very much from many conservation organizations, but in fact we should look for some different places to exhibit and to show them, not the halls and the closed areas. Even this is our bright new exhibition which will be open next week, which is in the middle of the town, and it's interesting usage of the ограда, как беше ограда, of the fence, of the fence of a building, and it's very attractive and interesting for the citizens. I want to share with you one idea which we have and which we organize for 10 years and more. It's annual biodiversity awards in Bulgaria. It's a special ceremony which we invented in order to present all good examples for the nature conservation and biodiversity conservation in Bulgaria. Every year we collect nominations in 5 different categories: for journalist, for campaign, for activist, for pro-biodiversity business, in order really to show the good examples, only the good examples. During the year we have a lot of bad experience and a lot of negative activities. So with this ceremony, with these awards, we want to be only positive, and it's really a celebration. We collect all people who are working this year for the biodiversity conservation, and it's huge celebration. You see the winners, they receive a basket with the farmer's food. There is famous musicians who perform during the ceremony, famous people who are part of the jury and who make the selection of all the nominations which we receive. And this is something which we are proud of, this Biodiversity Awards. It's not easy to organize them, but it's something on which people who work so hard during the year are needed. The other interesting communication activities which we started in 2005 is the year of every year we Biodiversity Foundation announced to mushrooms, to amphibians, plants in Bulgaria, butterflies. After that we started with the site for Tanasovsko Lake, Balkan, the year of biosphere parks, and it's a very interesting initiative. We are producing a simple calendar. Every year it's the same format, the same model, and organizing different activities related with the topic. And really pay attention to this group of animals or plants. Organizing different events all around the country. It's something which we can share with a pleasure, and we will be very happy if someone took this idea in their country. The case of the youngest natural park, Belasica, but maybe it's too late. So I'll just mention some other things. Educational course for biodiversity, which we use more than 10 years to communicate with young people about interesting topics. And now with this project, we are also trying to continue on one or another way this kind of meetings and contacts with the young people, and to share our important messages and achievements or problems with the young people. Of course, it's not always very positive. We must pay attention to the positive news and positive attitude, but also when it's necessary, you should communicate on different way. Joining protests, street actions, blocking the streets, because sometimes there are no other ways to negotiate with the government or with some private investors. But it's also very important to have a good communication. This year we have a very long experience with the protest for Pirin National Park. We started from the beginning of January and continue till the end of March. Even some towns continued later on. Every week there was a protest in more than 10 Bulgarian towns for the National Park Pirin. And finally, the campaign was successful, and the court gave back this illegal order of the Ministry of Environment. We are not prevented by the black PR. There are many media and even some organizations who work very hard to make to neglige our efforts and our work. There are many articles in the media, in some certain media, about the conflicts, about pet green guys, and they are teased, and there is many problems with their projects and things like this. You can see this is one of the ugliest photos which I saw through this campaign, comparing kids and this is also Natura for Millions, how that one of the NGO took millions for Natura 2000 in Bulgaria. But this is the part of the reality and the part of the environment in which we work, exist, and live. So it is important always to celebrate the good occasions and to organize nice events with music, with good atmosphere and people. To have a cake, a wine, and really to celebrate. In this case, we celebrate the birthday of Atanasovsko Lake. This lake is a very special one. We celebrate a birthday, we celebrate a name day with this half marathon, which I mentioned. We have a festival of the lake. It's really a special one. Also, to share all news via traditional or social media, because you know, if you are not in the media, it's nothing happen. And be grateful to all people that support your work. Never mind if there are volunteers or media or journalists or people who help with the funding, with the logistic. Always try to thank people. That's all from me. Thank you very much. And I want to welcome you here to visit the coastal lagoon of Atanasovsko Lake, which is a good example of well-managed Natura 2000 area, managed reserve, biodiversity hub, not only for Bulgaria, but Europe. We are now implementing our next project, the life project, the Lagoon of Life. So that's all for me. I'm waiting for your questions or comments or wherever you want to share with us. Thank you very much for your attention.